I personally, what I would ask this patient is, what is the topmost symptom which she's worried of or which is bothering her? Then, because it looks like she got multiple symptoms, then we can target our therapy to meet her expectation to start with. And also, we should not forget other symptoms at the same time. But I think meeting patient expectation is very important in this case, I think. So if you look at the pathophysiological research or physiological research in the evaluation of IBS, previously we used to think that it's mainly the gastric motility which is accountable for most of the patient symptoms. But as the time went on, we started to realize that there's been increased emphasis on visceral hypersensitivity, and of late we've been focusing more on gut-brain axis, of which visceral hypersensitivity forms part of it actually. So this is a schematic representation of the gut-brain axis, and we all know that the afferent pathway starts at the abdominal viscus, goes and relays at the dorsal root, and then from there the pain signals can be sent upstairs either through ipsilateral dorsal columns or contralateral spinothalamic tracts. So both the mechanisms of pain in this patient or in any other patient may be something to do with the disturbance at the receptor level, disturbance at the communication with other neurons, secondary neurons or interneurons levels, or maybe some disturbance at the perception itself. So all the therapies should be directed to one or most of these concepts actually. So if you look at the concept of visceral hypersensitivity, anybody who gets a noxious stimulus will send off a pain signal, and the injured area becomes more and more sensitive, and an innocuous stimulus which is not supposed to produce any pain signal starts to send the pain signal pathway. That is called allodynia. So allodynia happening in a particular site, the site of injury, it is called primary hyperalgesia, and the surrounding structure, surrounding tissue also becomes sensitive and starts to send out the pain signal. That is called secondary hyperalgesia. So all of these form a part of the visceral hypersensitivity, and this is one of the age old publication which started to establish the concept of visceral hypersensitivity. We all can know that a patient with IBS has got a very low threshold for inflation pressure, whether rectosigmoid balloon pressure, they start to experience more and more pain for a given amount of air volume. And the same concept has been applied and proved for other viscera such as esophagus, stomach and small intestine as well. Interestingly, these patients, visceral hypersensitivity is quite specific for their viscera actually. So if you test their pain threshold by putting their hands in the ice cold water, they will not show any significant difference compared to controls. But again, whereas if you test their colonic distension, there can be significant difference in the sensitivity pattern.